church on Sunday morning.
The year is 1897 in Thompsonville, Maryland, and that's the year my great-grandmother, Mary Magdalene Swan, was born. During her time, there was no high school. School only stopped at the sixth grade. After 3 years of sixth grade, she moved out on her own at the age of 18, where she met my great-grandfather, John Walter Hill, who was a sharecropper.
Played a tambourine so well, Grandma's hand. To issue out a warning, she'd say, Billy, don't you run so fast. Might fall on a piece of glass. Might be snakes there in that grass, Grandma's hand.
In 1940, John Walter Hill passed away. After he died, my Grandma Maggie made sure she had a place to live for her and her 10 children. She first bought 6 acres of land with $40, and after learning that her old school was being condemned, she took the lumber and built the house that she still has to this day.
Grandma's hand soothed the local unwed mother. Grandma's hand used to ache sometimes and swell. Grandma's hand used to lift her face and tell her she'd say, baby, Grandma, understand that you really love that man. Put yourself in Jesus' hands, Grandma's hand. Grandma's hand used to hand me a piece of candy. Grandma's hand picked me up each time.
I was born in Washington, D.C., but I lived in Prince George's County all of my life. I was raised in a single-parent household, and my mother tried her best to raise me right and made sure I had everything I needed. The one thing my mother wanted me to receive was a good quality education, which is why she sent me to private school. My mother is very strict when it comes to my grades. When I get anything lower than B's on my report card, she puts me on punishment until my grades get back up. Unlike my mother, who grew up with a twin sister, I was an only child. With no kids living in the house with me, I made a lot of friends with kids around my neighborhood. My family used to spoil me rotten with anything I asked for. My mother wanted me to have a quality education growing up, so she sent me to private school from pre-K to the 8th grade. When I started high school, I was transferred to a public school. I cried a little because of the things I heard about public school, especially Crossland. Private schools made kids think public school was the worst place to be, and when I started Crossland, it was everything I thought it would be. After a while, I became thankful that I went to public school instead of staying in private school, because private school shelters kids from what's really out there in the world today, and I think public school exposes you to these kinds of things. Everyone in my family, from my mom's generation on up, was Catholic. Throughout my childhood, I attended non-denominational churches, including Integrity Church International, Open Bible Ministries, and Victory Christian Ministries International. I never lived in a strict religious household, but when living with my grandmother, I always heard gospel music, and she had a huge collection of tapes and records she would play throughout the day. When I go visit my other Catholic family members, I liked going to see what Catholic churches were like, and I got to learn a lot more about Catholicism once I started Catholic school. The one thing I learned from my mother was to never let anyone control my life. There's no one in this world, even my own mother, that controls me, telling me what I can or cannot do. I remember when I first started applying for colleges, my original choice was the University of Miami, but my mother didn't like that school one bit. She made me apply to Ivy League schools like Harvard, Rutgers, and Stanford. And in the end, I ended up liking Rutgers. Although I never liked proving my mother wrong or right, but in this case, she always knew what was best for me.